All right, it's Wednesday, April 25th or 6th. It's 6:45 right now p.m. Wind just started blowing. I just started recording and the fucking wind just started blowing. I swear to you. It was calm. I started recording and the wind started blowing. Unbelievable. Shout out to the sunflowers are coming up here. My wind fencing, my sunflower fence. Look at those suckers. But we got some tomato plants over here. Tiny ones. I'm not going to go in too far. Right there. That one looks awful right there. But that one is too. But the wind out here, again, is bad. We're trying to... Oh, just stepped in water. We're trying to tie them up as best as possible. See, sometimes when it's got a bad leaf on it like this, you have to cut it off with your thumb. You know, get the diseased leaf off of it. Spread. On the bottom down here, there's two of them. God bless them. There. All three of them. Anyway, I got those leaves pinched off. Can't let them get in there. See this plant here? It's about 7 inches tall. That's another small one right down there. But look at that one there. This one over here. P, you going in with mommy? Go on. Go on, go in the house. Gotta get the dogs to go in. Go on in the house, use the steps. Lucy will jump up, she had hurt before, so. Okay, here's a bean. After I showed those tomatoes briefly. Up front here, I got the bean right down there. I got this leaf on my hand. I'm trying to get down in here with no one. Well, we can't infect any of the others. See that bean right there, and this aisle here, this is toward the center of the garden, going east to west. Got that bean, one bean there. Got a bean there. That's a bush, that's a flora bean, yeah. Okay, and I planted that one bean there. Where was that? Right down there. And over there, and there, and there, but none is growing on these yet. One's starting to come up there, right there. I got two in that hole there. Got one right here. I got the second one growing. See that little line right there? That's one, and then that one right there. Yep. One over here. I thought there was two in there, but I know I got one. See, I'm trying to look, and I'm not looking on the camera, so I keep going off the beam. And I got one coming up there. That's odd. That's odd looking. Looks like a stem of a beam bent over. Then you come over here where the fencing is, we got... don't know, that's not nothing I planted. Right here is bean. That's bean right down there. Where's that? Right there. Okay, that's as far as the back beans are planted. We go up through the fencing for them to crawl on. Up here. I got two down there in that hole. That's the... two right there. Got one right here. Take this off my neck so I can get the camera down closer. Okay. We got... that's it. Going back this way here. I didn't plant any beans back in this first four. Up right here, the first two rows of beans. I got, there's two bean plants down there. I don't know if they're coming out good on the video. Got wind blowing here in my eyes. So, there's two, there's a small one down there. So Whoops. And we got these up here. Right there. And those two right there. Okay, then we come over here and there's watermelon and cantaloupe. Nothing in this front row here. I don't understand why these aren't coming up. They did that last year too. Some of them didn't come up and the others came up almost right away. Because right back here, right there, you can see that one right there. And then, one right there. Okay. And then I went ahead and put some okra down back here. One there. One while these steaks, these tomato steaks are. I put some seeds. And these are just put down about 2 days ago. So nothing will be any of these holes back here. Now let's get out of this garden. As you can see, you can't really see the angle good here, but the sun is setting in the west. And the sunflowers, when they come up in the east, they're facing the east. And then as it goes like this midday, and then they start going west. They actually follow the sun. It's incredible how they do that. When they get a little bit bigger and they actually have the flowers, that's how they do until they get full flowered. The yellow ones, I believe, might still follow the sun. The torch ones are like a nice bush with pretty flowers on them. See, this is the what I call my wind fence. It'll be all these. But see, I planted a bunch of flowers down here, which I'm not gonna rake up anymore right now. I was gonna go ahead and plant some more sunflowers down here. Like I said, there's a sunflower right there growing. I can't really see it on the video right there. Them two petals together. Yeah, it's out of focus. Anyway, that's the sunflower that's growing. Probably the yellow. And look at all these. Look at all these, how they're facing the sun. See how they're facing the sun? As the sun sets in the west, the sunflower just goes like that. It faces the west. It's amazing. These are plants now. Look at that. Look at that. See that? I think it's just, to me, it's pretty cool to see them. In the morning, you'll see them. It'll be just like that, but they'll be facing that way, facing east when the sun's coming up. Over in the number two garden here, we got two cucumbers, three cucumbers up here at the front. At this end. And I don't see anything coming through the soil yet. There's a, we call it a black beauty zucchini, which is your classic green zucchini. You can see it right there, it's coming up. See that green leaf, the leaves right there? I don't know, I'm zooming too much. Right in the center there is green leaves. That's the green black beauty zucchini. And then when it gets a little bit bigger, it'll look like these right here. This is the golden zucchini, the yellow zucchini. One right there, two right there coming up. We planted three on this side of that board. Two are coming up. The other one's not coming up yet. On the other side of the board over here, got that one right there. Golden zucchini, yellow zucchini, basically. With one planted there, nothing's coming up yet. But this one's planted and that one's coming up. Okay. And then right here, I just put a pumpkin seed down. Last year we had pumpkins we thought were zucchini, and what a mess that was. I just planted one pumpkin seed. It's been about 2 weeks, 3 weeks maybe. 2 weeks, I would say, 2 weeks. Over here, we planted 12 ears of corn, 12 corns. And we got, as of right now, you can't really see it good on here, but there's one down there, there's one. There's a stalk of corn right there, two, three, and over there, four, five. I thought I saw seven, because there's six right there. Where is it? Right there is six. I got the sun in my eyes right now, so I can't really see them good. But they're about an inch and a half out of the ground. And let's see, one, two, three, Okay. Three in the second set. And three in the other set, so six. And then we got zucchini over here. And okra. But it's still too early for that to be popping up just yet. Today is Wednesday. Saturday is when we expect to see a couple. Saturday there should be a big change. There should be some more rain tomorrow. Tomorrow or the next day we're supposed to have rain. We had brief showers out here. But we'll start having okra popping out. See, oh, right there's one. Oh, I don't want to see. It's difficult because we got flowers planted all around the garden here. When we did this, when we broke up the soil with a tiller, which I really highly recommend you getting a tiller if you're going to make a garden. But look at this. Oh, I didn't see that. That one's really, that's okra right there. That'll put out until late October, possibly even November. Once it starts putting out, it just puts out big time. We did that last year in the back garden, the number three garden. Number three garden is where the tomatoes and the beans are over there, and the watermelon came up at the end. This is the number one garden I'm walking on. Oh, yeah. And I planted marigolds, and so did other flowers, on the mounds of dirt all the way around the garden, where we dug it out to put on top of the plastic to bury it. That's what helps it grow. If it wasn't for the wind, by the beginning of, about the second week of April, this, what you're seeing right now, with this being the last week of April, about the first week of April, second week at the latest, that's where the plants that you see right now would be at that stage. I mean, you got these big beans right now that are about 5 inches above the ground. And the corn. And the tomatoes. Now think about that, having 3 weeks ahead of time. So by the second week of June, you'd have your tomatoes coming up. You'd have more than enough red tomatoes and green tomatoes at the same time. And we've got about 12 more tomatoes planted. We got spots out there for 14 more tomatoes in the number three garden back there. But there's that one okra I just saw. I can't see, with the sun in my eyes and the damn wind, as you can see by my wind socks, my plastic strips I use as wind socks. Where is that one at? Right there, see it? Out of the south. I think the south wind is supposed to be like 17 mile an hour gusts. The wind is like 5 to 6 mile an hour, 17 mile an hour gusts. But if you look at it, it's more like, you know, constant 12 mile an hour wind. So that's a marigold we transplanted down here. We had six of them. They all died except for that one. My wife transplanted it right down there. Plus, I put seeds of marigolds all down the edges, like I said. We got marigolds, and we have different types of flowers that are all medicinal. You know, it's different stuff for upset stomachs, for pain relief, for, you know, menstrual cramps. I mean, just all types of stuff from heirloom solutions. And we plant them all around both gardens. This is the number one garden right here, the first one here, where the okra and then the corn is growing. And then over there where we have the zucchini, and then we're gonna have cucumbers and one pumpkin, of course. But see, all around the edges there, we put flower seeds, you know, marigolds and then some other stuff. Phlox, P-H-L-O-L-Y-X or something like that. And a bunch of, and like I say, there's all types of heirloom seeds. That's just amazing. But I have them all around these two smaller gardens. Next year we're going to cut the back one like these two. It's easier to take care of a smaller garden than it is that one big one, actually. So we're going to cut the plastic like that and have a walkway so it'll look like a big cross out here. And we'll lose about three rows. But like I said, we look at how we have right here, all that access right here. There's nothing growing in there. Right where that stake is, there is a bean. There's a bean just on the other side of that cinder block. Okay, so we're gonna lose. Well, technically, the way I've got it right now, I use a lot of space. I got one bean on each side of that watering pot. I've planted one or two seeds, and then one on the other side, like a triangle. And then same thing with the yellow bottle over there, a bean on each side and one in the middle. So six beans there, 6 to 12 beans, depending on how I plant it. Then two here, two right there by that stake, one on each side of that cinder block. So that's what we're gonna lose, all that right there. Plus, we'll probably change it around a little bit as far as what's going to be planted. Because, like I say, last year we had okra back there. We had tomatoes right here. And we had pumpkin, thinking it was zucchini. I don't know, like I said, didn't know at the time. We had pumpkin run amok over there. And we couldn't hardly get anything to grow over in this garden. But like I said, right now we've got the golden zucchini growing. And I thought the traditional green black beauty zucchini is growing over here. So, and then like I said, we got our six garlic here that we planted. The cloves about the first week of November or end of October. They'll be ready about June sometime. Then we planted these out here about 4 weeks ago, about 3 weeks ago. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Eight more cloves of garlic we put down there. So when they come up, let's see, we plant those, let's just say April. April, May, June, July, August. See, right around September. Because the other was November. November, December, January, February, March, April, May, June. So about 8 months. So April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November. Oh, almost November. November and April is when we should plant. So, like I say, each one of these will give you a bulb, which will have about 12, I would say, approximately, cloves on it of heirloom garlic. It's not the crap you buy in the store. Garlic is being a big, healthy thing for people. You need to grow your own. I would not trust anything but heirloom. Hybrid has been specifically, has been genetically altered. It's almost the same thing as GMO. Almost, like I say, it's like a derivative of GMO, genetically modified organisms. It's gene spliced to be a certain type, you know, so it's not pure. These are pure. These are like seeds from 50, 60 years ago. That's the purity of the seed before Monsanto started polluting everything. So, and like I said, we got sweet corn in here. We got 12 years, of which there are six right now. I think seven maybe coming up, but six for sure. Oh, boy. We got peppers growing. It started in the house from seed. There's some over here we had from seed. We got a few of them out here. I mean, they were just transplanted. With the wind being as bad as it is, they're doing okay for that. You know, look at that one there. That's one that lasted since last year. We got it out of the garden. The leaves are almost out because of the wind. That was a fully leaved pepper plant right there. And we got 1, 2, 3. It's real tiny. 4 in the back. 5. That real 6, 7. 8, 9. And that one right down there. Can barely see it. There's one right in that first hole there. 10, 11. 11 pepper plants. This one was the big one. Like I said, it was big in the house all winter. We go out here and the winds out here, if you look at them, the one that says winds from hell, you'll see what I'm talking about. You know, when the winds, when they say 6 mile an hour winds with wind gusts of 12 to 18 miles an hour out here, you're talking about maybe 15 to 20 miles an hour winds, wind gusts of about 35. One more shot of the garden from over here. You just look at the wind socks, the plastic I have tied onto the tomato stakes. That's the wind out here. And that's how it is. Six out of 7 days, this is how the wind is out here. So, we're doing the best we can. But we're doing something. We've been blessed enough to have a place where we can grow some stuff. I don't know what I would do if we were in a town where we didn't have a yard even. Or if our garden would be no bigger than that right there. Boy, would that really suck. Like I said, we've got that. That's really nice. It's a lot of work, but like I said, it's healthy food. Very healthy food.